A constitutional lawyer believes Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia has the right to remove the outdoor mask mandate in her province. Attorney Tony Lavinia says under the constitution and the local government code, local government units have the autonomy to decide on certain matters without having to go through the national government unit. Last week, Governor Garcia issued an executive order saying face masks are no longer mandatory in outdoor settings. She cited the improved COVID situation in the province as her basis for easing the rule, but the Interior Department said it will not recognize her EO since existing protocols dictate that face masks can only be taken off when eating or while participating in sports activities in well-ventilated venues. For his take on this, we are joined on the line by Marinduque Governor Presbytero Velasco Jr. He's the president of the League of Provinces of the Philippines. Good morning, sir. Thank you for joining us.
Morning, Nikki, and to all viewers of Rundown ANC.
All right. Thank you for taking our call, sir. First off, what does your group think of the controversial decision of, you know, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia to no longer require mask wearing in indoors, well-ventilated settings? Is this a reasonable regulation?
Well, under the Bayanihan Law 2, RA 11494, or particularly Section 4, the President is authorized to exercise powers that are necessary and proper to undertake and implement COVID-19 interventions, whether response or recovery interventions. And one of the powers of the President is to see to it that all local government units act within the meaning and spirit of all the rules, regulations, and directives issued by the national government, and in this case, the IATF. And the LGUs may, however, exercise its autonomy as prescribed under RA 11494 for matters undefined by the national government or supplemental to the parameters the IATF has set. So based on this, the local government units are obliged to follow the directives of the IATF. And since the IATF has issued a resolution requiring the mandatory wearing of face masks even outdoors with certain exceptions, no, then the local government units have to follow the directive of the IATF.
Mm-hmm. And sir, where do we draw the line then, you know, considering that to a certain extent, everyone knows that local governments do have their autonomy, but then it can be invalidated by a proper authority. Where's the line drawn here?
Well, there is a law that we should follow, which is RA 11494. And it is stated very clearly under Section 4, I think letter P, no, that we have to follow the directives and resolutions of the IATF on COVID interventions and matters, no? So it is explained clearly in said law that for other matters which are not covered by IATF resolutions, then the local government units can exercise its power to prescribe reasonable rules and regulations. But, you know, this is a matter of national concern and interest, no? And it is best that we follow the law or the rules or resolutions issued by the agency tasked to handle this pandemic. And that being so, and the provision of the law is clear, that only on matters which are undefined or not covered by the IATF resolutions can we exercise our power to enact or pass or issue executive orders.
So, sir, the variable to look at here is IATF and, of course, the pandemic situation that no one did see happening. But Governor Garcia invoked certain sections of the local government code granting the exercise of autonomy among local officials like herself, including Section 105, which authorizes the national government to manage the health situation in any given locality for up to 6 months before the local government concerned takes over. So what are your thoughts on this? It has been well over 6 months already.
Well, the president is still exercising its special powers under the law, and we have to follow the directives issued by the IATF as authorized by the president. If anybody would like to contest it, then we have to go to the courts to determine whether these are within the bounds of the Bayanihan 2 law. I think that's the best way of determining or resolving an issue.
And how do you think the public, particularly civil residents, will take this news? Will they opt to follow the LGU mandate or stick to the IATF rules?
Well, we have the rule of law. We have to follow the laws or directives or executive orders issued by the president. Otherwise, there will be anarchy. Actually, in the AATF resolution, there are exceptions provided where one is allowed not to wear the mask, especially, say, when you're eating or dining or when you're into outdoor sports or when they're you're doing outdoor exercises, but you have to keep the proper distance, no? And I think there are good reasons behind the directive of the IATF because there is, I think, an increase now in the number of infections of the COVID, no? And
yes,
you have to consider that in other neighboring countries. I think the IATF resolution is reasonable and meritorious. Anyway,
and we have new subvariants, sir, and then we have the monkeypox.
Yes,
so many things to consider, boy.
And bacteria and everything. And I think the government, national government, the president means well. mean well when they when the IATF issued the question, the resolution. You have to well, it's discretionary on your part. If you don't want to wear it, and if you're not caught, so well and good.
But, and sir, you mentioned kanina, no? Anarchy pa nga eh. Huwag naman po sana. But, you know, even top police officials in Cebu are also in an apparent dilemma as to whether or not they should follow the national government, interior and provincial chief executive, amid the issued conflicting policies. Kanino ka po ba papanig, no? We have Colonel Soriano, the director of the Cebu Provincial Police Office, CPPO, saying that he would be guided by the new mandate. But then you have his regional superior, Brigadier General Vega, naman, urging the public to continue wearing face masks in open spaces. So what's your take on this, na even top officials in Cebu are having this confusion among themselves?
I believe they're correct. We have to follow the law. Otherwise, if we do not follow the law, the provisions thereof, then there will be anarchy. There may be breakdown of peace and order because there has to be rules to be followed, especially in this case when we still have a big problem with the COVID.
Sir, do you think then that there's a possibility of other provinces following suit, most especially those that have less COVID cases than Cebu and are under alert level 1?
Well, it's up to the local chief executive. They know the law. They know their duties under the law, and they know we have to follow the law. So what happens is if somebody or a local chief executive issues a directive which the national government may believe not to be in compliance with the resolutions or directives they issued, what usually happens is that they are asked to explain, there has to be due process, and GovGwen may have good reasons also, but the provisions or the parameters should be made very, very clear, because even the IATF resolution has prescribed certain exceptions to the wearing of masks outdoors.
And sir, lastly, following the confusion, all this brought about by Cebu's new EO, how do you think this should ultimately be addressed and resolved between the national government and the LGU?
Secretary Anyo usually does is he will talk to GovGwen and discuss the matter, and on the part of the LPP, I will talk to GovGwen and discuss the matter with her.
All right. On that note, thank you so much for clarifying many things for us this morning. Sir Crespitero, you stay safe.
Thank you very much. Stay safe.